Hello dear students, I hope you are doing fine. In today's class, we will start with the unit 4 of BED code 102, that is learning and teaching. And the topic I'm taking today is meaning and nature of personality. Personality is a characteristic way of thinking, feeling, and behaving. Personality embraces moods, attitudes, opinions, and is most clearly expressed in interactions with the people. We have a misconception that personality only consists of the persona or the outer look. But when we talk about personality at large, it contains everything that makes us who we are. The word personality has been derived from the Latin word persona, which means to speak through. The term was basically used by the Greek actors. They used to wear these masks to perform their plays, and such as they related it to the personalities that people always in front of the other people wear the masks. In these coming two next slides, there will be the definitions of personality given by Alport, Roach, Kettle, and Munn. Now let's talk about the nature of personality. The first point which is that it is something unique for every individual. As we all know that we all have different personalities, different qualities, different way of taking things, different aspects, different opinions. So that is why it is said that it is unique for every individual and two personalities cannot be same. Next point is, personality refers particularly to persistent qualities of an individual, which means that they are the permanent traits. When we talk about personality, these are the permanent traits or the qualities which are there, which are present in our behavior. Some are by birth and some are acquired with the help of environment and the adjustments we make around ourselves. Third point is, personality is greatly influenced by social interactions. As I said earlier also, that personality is not only about our inborn traits. We learn a lot or we get influenced a lot by interacting with the others. So that is why our personality is greatly influenced by the social interactions we make with the people. The fourth point is, personality is the outcome of interaction of heredity and environment. As I said, that some of the traits are inborn, some of the traits are learned and which are acquired from the environment. So that is why personality consists of the outcome or the interaction of both the factors, that is heredity as well as environment. Fifth point says, personality is a dynamic whole, which means that personality is not static. It is an active part of ourselves and it consists of the everything which makes us, the views, the attitudes, the belief system, the inborn traits, all of the comprehensive things form the personality as a dynamic whole. Now let's talk about the determinants of personality. There are two main determinants of personality. One is the biological factors and the other is environmental factors. The biological factors includes physique and personality, intelligence, sex differences and nervous system, whereas the environmental factors include geographical environment, childhood experiences, school and culture. Now, the first point of the biological factors is physique and personality. There are so many things which influence the development of the personality. Physical development also influences the development of personality. Factors such as, you know, height, weight, physical defect, outlook. And the next point is intelligence. Intelligence is basically the thinking power of humans. So, persons who are very intelligent, they can make adjustments very easily as compared to others. The third point is sex differences. We have always seen that, you know, boys are more assertive, tough-minded, vigorous, and girls, take less interest in the outdoor activities. They show more interest in the fine arts or things like that. So sex differences play a very important role in the formation of or the development of personality. Environmental factors include geographical environment and childhood experiences. The place where we live, the environment, the surroundings, neighborhood, they also play a very important role in shaping the personality. Similarly, the childhood experiences, they also play a major role in molding and shaping the personality that we have. The last two points in environmental factors include school and culture. Of course, as we all know that school plays a very, very important role in the development of personality. The child gets, very much influenced by the personality of the teachers, of the fellow mates, of the peers, and they learn a lot from them. Similarly, the culture, the cultural traditions of the society we live in, they influences our thought process as well as the personality traits. So, dear students, this was all about meaning, nature and determinants of the personality. In the next videos to come, we'll discuss more of this in the unit 4. So, thank you for watching.